Canada's Minister of Global Affairs was considered such a lightweight and prone to errors that she wasn't given many tasks at all before she got to Global Affairs. Now she's going to be dealing with China, the United States, the whole world, and Canada's very tenuous position as far as a heavyweight country. And the rest of the cabinet, a bunch of sycophants. It's large, bloated. A lot of people are saying, what is going on in Ottawa? Well, Brian Lilley, who's with the Toronto Sun, joins me right now. And what is going on in Ottawa? People are looking at that cabinet and saying, we have some smart people, they aren't in the cabinet.
This is, John Iveson put it down in the National Post the other day, this is the first NDP government. I mean, this is a cabinet and a government that is not recognizable to past liberals, maybe like yourself.
Well, I have issues with this cabinet, with this government, and with Mr. Trudeau. But, you know, you're absolutely right in the sense that people look at it, and they say, well, you know, they are sycophants. And Trudeau needs someone to be able to tell him, you know, this is a different point of view, this is a different view. Otherwise, he ends up on the beach at Tofino all the time.
Yeah, and I don't think he's got that. As far as Melanie Joly, who was Heritage Minister, did such a bad job. You remember the skating rink?
Skating rink. Millions and millions and millions of dollars, and no one could use it.
And it was a disaster. The Canada 150 celebrations, a disaster. These were her big files. They were her big mistakes.
Yeah.
And so she got demoted to tourism. Then she got demoted to, well, look after official languages, but don't say much. And now she's suddenly Canada's voice to the world. Well, what's the voice going to say?
Is it because she's such a sycophant that she'll just agree with everything that Trudeau does?
I really can't figure out what Justin Trudeau's doing in putting her in such a high-profile job, getting rid of Mark Garneau, dropping Bartosz Chagger, keeping Harjit Sajjan, keeping Carolyn Bennett. Carolyn Bennett, I didn't think she was fit to be cabinet when she was in Paul Martin's government.
Well, and she's been there for 6 years in Indigenous affairs or related ministries, and a lot of people look at it and say, she's not achieved anything.
No.
Because Natives tell me, just give us clean water, fulfill your promises, and she hasn't been able to do that.
No. So this is a government that is big on gestures, but low on results. And it doesn't matter what the file is, whether it's clean drinking water or foreign affairs. Remember, this was a government that made foreign affairs a massive part of their 2015. Canada's back, baby! And they're going to, you know, show the world, well, what was our first big foray into foreign affairs? Well, we're going to make nice with Iran and Russia. That didn't work out too well. We're going to bring back UN peacekeeping. That never happened. We're going to do great with China. Well, they showed us the back of the hand. You know, we've had a second Democrat for this prime minister in the White House, and he can't get anything out of them. It's not just Trump. He can't get anything out of Joe Biden.
Ah, but we are virtuous. Brian Lilley, thank you very much. 3 minutes. The hallmark of a free society is an independent press. And in Canada, increasingly, we don't have an independent press when the PMO pays many outlets to say what they say. This station is independent. It's free. And if you can contribute, please do so, because we want to stay on the air. We have people on this show who analyze the situation and provide facts that otherwise you would get in the press. So thank you. Subscribe. You can contribute.